This is cool. I'm going to be the first paddler to paddle in to the paddle in sites at Pittock Conservation Area in Woodstock, Ontario. It's kind of cool. They just opened them and booked it just before the long weekend, so that was smart. Solitude at Pittock. Let's have a look. So Pittock Conservation Area, basically it's the reservoir just before the upper portion of the south branch of the Thames River in southwestern Ontario. I paddled the whole Thames a couple weeks ago and did a whole video series on that. I started just downstream from here and was traveling through to do some work on that story, and you need a place to camp, so maybe get rained on. But you know, it's supposed to storm all day today. This is kind of cool. There's a campground here. There's two trailer sites, I think, sort of more semi-wilderness sites along here. I'm at Boat Launch 2, and along Boat Launch 1, there's more trailer sites, more open sites. So you're probably like, okay, Kevin, like, what are you doing down south all the time? Like, what's going on with you? I always travel the far north, right? Always have. That's not really the case. I grew up in Milton, Ontario, and I paddled the Thames, the Grand, the Credit, the Saugeen. I think sometimes people in general like going back in time where they had fond memories. And I had fond memories growing up in Milton. I mean, Milton is not at all like it was back then. It was a farm community back then. But I used to play in the woodlots, fish in the trout streams, paddle the rivers, things like that. Rockwood, that's a good place too. The Nith, that's a fantastic run. Pittock. So now that they have interior sites, why not? Why not? Very cool. You're in the middle of suburbia, but you wouldn't know it. Quite nice. Lots of aspen. Actually trembling aspen. Cottonwood. And spruce. Nobody else. So when I got here, they gave me a key. And the key opens up the outhouse and the firebox. Or firewood box. Not firebox, firewood box. There is a trail coming in here. I think you can actually hike to this spot as well. You don't have to boat to it. Awesome! Well, one advantage of Pittock sites, they're not too far away from the access point, which is good, because I forgot my toilet paper. So I had to go and get some. I'm going back to site. I don't know if you can see that behind me, but the trees of that maple there are flipping in the wind, showing their underbellies, their white underbelly. Poplars are really well known for that, trembling aspen especially, because they have a loose petiole. But that means the barometer's dropping and weather's coming in. It is starting to rain. But if just the tops of the tree is flipped, that means it's gonna rain for a couple hours. If the whole entire tree's flipped, that's a good 6 to 12 hours at least. So something's coming in. Look at this. So rain is a-coming, so first thing I'm going to do, I'm going to set up a tarp. There's so many ways to put a tarp up, four corners, ridge line. Here, it's pretty open space. I want to put the tarp over by the fire so I can have a fire tonight. So I'm going to do a ridge line, or attempt to do a ridge line. The ridge line I'm going to use is my baling rope. And why is I can put a little rock in there, throw it over the limb, so it acts as a little assistance. In theory. It's in the hole. Okay, so I need more rope. This rope isn't long enough to go across. So I need to tie two ropes together. First you do this knot to make a loop. Ta-da! Show that again. And then, this is a fisherman's knot. So what you do is you twist this around. The snake goes around the tree at least 6 times so it doesn't slip on you. Put the snake through the hole there. Yank on it. Yank on this. And yeah, there's lots of other ways to do that, but that's what I've always done. I like the fisherman's knot because you can just pull it really quickly and then it does really quickly. Well, the one thing you gotta remember to bring when you're at Pittock, mosquitoes are coming out before the storm, is your own water. Fresh water. I'm assuming you can't or shouldn't drink Pittock reservoir water. Maybe you can and filter it. But I mean, really, there's no portaging or anything else, so just bring your own water. So there's a bit of poison ivy around here, not much actually, and it's back in the bush, so it's not around the campsite. And that's common for southern Ontario. And here's the thing, like how you get it is that the resin that's coming up from the roots, and it's in the stem, gets into your bloodstream, and then you react to it. And some people say, oh, I'm fine with poison ivy, I can walk right through it, I can bathe in it, I'll never get it. You will get it. It's not how acceptable you are to it. It's actually when the resin is going up and down the stem. Like in the spring and fall, especially when the leaves are gone and you brush against the stem, that's a really good time to get it. You do get it for 7 years, the 7-year itch idea. And whether it's 7 years or 3 years, whatever, it stays in your bloodstream. And it's really nasty stuff. So what will happen is that you'll get it really bad, you'll get it fixed. And then even when you walk near it, your body reacts to it. And it just it goes through your bloodstream again. And yeah, so if you get it, it's going to last you for a while. Collective Soul has an album called 7-Year Itch. I bet you that's not why they call it that. I think it was a collection of all their 7 years of, I don't know. But anyway, don't mess with poison ivy. Well, I just got my bag of wood from the wood box. And each bag comes with one of these. That's kind of cool. It's a fire starter. Homemade fire starter. Oh, I'm bleeding. Oh, I'm bleeding. Ugh. Ooh. Got it. First aid. I cut myself somehow. Be back. Ah, blood on my pants. Yeah, so I cut myself on the, I don't know, what is it, a twig or something. So, got my first aid kit out. A little travel one. I like this one for solo trips. Ultra light, waterproof. And I have a tendency to add a few more things in it. I gotta clean that out. That's, how did I do that? Wipe. Clean off. I'm gonna use this for fire starter. I think it has alcohol in it. Oh, that's deep. Holy. Ah. Nobody panic. Don't panic. Worst thing to do is panic. Holy crap. I'm gonna have to put two on there. All right, anyway, what was I saying? Fire starter, and I was going to show you how to safely chop wood. I haven't even picked the axe up yet, there's blood everywhere. You never know when it's going to happen. Make sure you have a good first aid kit, make sure you know how to use it. Don't panic. Oh yeah, and the axe I'm using, it's a new one I got this winter. Used for winter camping and brought along. Woodcraft by Council Tool. Boy, it needs the rust taken off. Sorry, I haven't used this since the winter. But love it. Really lightweight, nice size. But I love the bevel in it, so it actually helps the wood split. My preferred way to clean this, I got steel wool and I got WD-40. And I use Coca-Cola, I've done all these other things, whatever, to clean it. But WD-40 with a steel wool, and I'll take that rust off really nice. It's still sharp, just rusty.
Yeah. My name is Becky, and I am the Conservation Area Clerk here at Pittock Conservation Area. So we decided that there was a desire and a need for an interior site not too far from home. So the great thing about this is you're not too far from the city, and it's a great starting point to explore interior camping in the province as a whole. I think that there was a desire from within like park staff itself, just trying to come up with new ideas. You see a lot of people talking about going to Algonquin and other interior camping places and how great of an experience it can be. So we just decided that it might be time to try something like that here at home. We have in the plans for possibility of a second site, but as of right now, we just have the one site that we focused on getting prepared and getting open.
And I'm the first one to use it?
You are the first one to use it. And let us know what it's all about.
Well, time for bed. You can hear the thunder roaring in the distance, so things are going to happen real quick. Just going to read for a bit. And have a sip of speckled hen. Some may say that this is a bad tasting beer. And they might be right, but it's all memory stuff. When I first went to Scotland, oh gosh, my daughter was 5 years old. That's what I drank. When we paddled the northwest coast. Oh my lord, that was an amazing trip. The scenery is amazing. Sometimes you have a sip of a good tasting beer, and sometimes you have a sip of a memory. Good memory. They definitely need more sites.
Well, that's the night at Pittock Conservation Area. I survived the storm. She wasn't so bad. Moved on. Quite nice morning. Bald eagle perched right by my campsite, but I can't film it. It's on the other tree. I can hear him. That's kind of cool. It's a nice place in the south. Nice place to get away, try interior camping for a bit, canoeing, paddling, camping for a bit. See if you like it, or if you just want a quick weekend away with the kids and get away from the crowds. It's pretty cool. All right, off I go into the sunrise.